Okay, in this session, I'm going to walk you through profiles. I don't want to confuse anybody about profiles because some people think profiles are permissions, and profiles are not permissions. They are user personalizations, if you will, that when you, as a user, enters Business Central, you have specific pages and tasks related to your profile that you log into. So each user could be assigned a different profile, and each profile dictates what pages you are going to see. Not that you can't see other pages by drilling down in different areas, but it's your initial entry of Business Central where you'll have specific menus and specific pages that pertain to your profile, your role. But again, it's not permissions. It doesn't mean you can't do other functions with it. It just makes your life every day easier because it basically customizes your access within the system to only see certain areas within your role. So let me give you an example. So if I go into my settings and I go to my settings, typically most of the time people are going to be set up as a business manager role, which as you can see, in the background, business management role is, you know, basically gives you a lot of many things, finance, cash management, sales, purchasing, etc. Because you're a business manager, you basically could see all areas within Business Central. And again, that you're visually seeing, it's not permissions, you're not locked out of anything. But if I was to say, I want to set my role up because I'm an AR or AP coordinator, let's choose AP coordinator. And I click OK. It's going to refresh. And now you'll see the page that when you log in as you're assigned an AP coordinator, how things change, right? So now instead of all those menus that are being hidden, I'm only going to see vendors, purchase orders, invoices, credit memos, etc. Things that belong and pertain to you as a purchasing coordinator. An AP coordinator. And you see even the insights and stats that you have here are pertaining to the AP coordinator. So you see it's all AP. So let's do another example. So I'm going to go back to my settings and let's change this to an AR administrator. I'm going to refresh. And now you'll see it looks similar but yet different. Now it's all customers, sales orders, sales invoices, etc. So based on your profile that you assign yourself, or maybe the administrator actually assigns these profiles to you, every single time you log into Business Central, you'll see the pages and statistics around those areas that you're assigned to based on the profile. And again, I want to remind you, it's not permissions. You could still access AP if I was to do a search, for an example, because I'm an AR role, but if I wanted to type in a purchase order, I could still access purchase orders. So, you know, that's where purchase orders, if you want to control where people could be, is through permissions. And we'll talk about permissions in a different session. But for now, we're going to focus on profiles. So it's basically a user-defined page that you go to. What we can also do within these profiles, and now I'm going to search on profiles, just to give you an example of what's out there. These profiles, also considered roles, here's all out-of-the-box standardized profiles, okay? So you have a whole bunch of them already pre-existing. If, for an example, if I go back and close out and I see this, this is my AR coordinator, administrator, if there's still certain areas I don't want them to go into or at least easily have access to it, then I could also customize this for them, which is also considered a personalization. So I can make my own customized profiles if I wanted to, and then assign them to the user. And by doing that, again, I'm going to go back into profiles. And what I could do, if I have an AR administrator, I'm going to click on this. I'm going to copy this into a new one, and I'll just do AR. I'll just say AR2. Okay, so I'm just going to say AR2. I click OK. So what I did is I basically copied the original standard out of the box AR administrator, because you don't want to affect that. You always want to keep the original one. So I copied it into a new one. This is considered a customized one. And once I go into here, I could then customize how I want it to look and present and then assign it to the user. So for example, maybe I don't want them to go into the bank accounts. So I could go in there and I could hide it, right? Maybe they're never going to use reminders. Well, I'm just going to hide it. I don't do finance charge memos. I'm going to hide it. Okay, so you could see how I could do that. Conversely, I could also add fields. I can move fields around. Maybe journal entries again. I don't want them. They're not going to do journal entries, so I'm going to hide it. Okay, so I could, you know, so keep in mind, look all these I hid. So I'm going to click done. And now, if I go back into my settings and I change this to AR2, it will refresh. And now you will notice my menus up here. You don't see the journal entries, the bank accounts, etc., because I actually hid it based on my hiding of profiles. So I could customize my profile. When I customize that profile, now I'm doing it for everybody. Of course, everybody could do it as a user-by-user basis if they wanted to. Again, I'll talk about that in a different session called personalization. But the profiles, again, is something that when you log into the system, based on your profile assigned to that user, you will be able to see only those tasks. And again, you're not preventing those tasks. You're only going to see those tasks within those pages. Thanks for watching. If we could further assist you, please reach out to us here at epcgroup.net.